Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. If you love this watch, email me, tmosso@thewatchbox.com. It's in the description below. Your purchase and pricing email question line for buying this or any watch you see on any Watchbox platform. Please reach out to me directly. Email tmosso@thewatchbox.com. Today, we're discussing a beautiful, and I mean classically gorgeous, craft art white gold dress watch from Patek Philippe. This is the Patek Philippe Calatrava 5022G-001. 33 millimeters in diameter, the watch is ultra thin. It's 6.8 millimeters thick and 38.7 millimeters from lug to lug with an 18 millimeter span between the lugs. This is an old school men's dress watch. In terms of its sizing, it harks back to the middle of the 20th century and the heyday of Holy Trinity dress timepieces. It is a unisex option as well, as at 33 millimeters, it looks good on any wrist. My wrist at 16 centimeters circumference wears it well, and I would say just about any wrist will find this a flattering piece. It's super slim and will slide underneath the cuff, so if you're a lady who prefers men's watches or you're a man who has a taste for tradition, this watch is going to be a perfect match for you. Taking a quick look at the hardware and the software, you can see the watch includes a simple white gold polished spade style Patek Philippe pin buckle. It features a Patek Philippe factory strap, and as you can see, it is a large rectangular scale alligator leather on the top. It has a sheer cut side, it is black, it has a monotone stitch, and this is a brand new Patek Philippe factory strap with calfskin on the bottom. The timepiece includes a lovely, almost razor sharp case band. You can see the lugs are distinct, quite pronounced and gorgeous. The case itself features a little bit of a character line that runs circumferentially, as there is a domed gaudron style bezel, giving the watch immense personality. The lugs are strong, project straight out, and the crown is a simple Calatrava cross. Now you can see this is a warm white gold case as opposed to steel or platinum, and that tone is reciprocated on the dial, where the numerals themselves are made of white gold, as are the hands at center. Now, I mentioned this as a craft art piece. I mean, this is real rose-lathe guilloche. This dial was not stamped. The numerals themselves are made of white gold, as are the hands. But inboard of the outer track, which you can see is a silver satin metallic, you can see an exceptional rose-lathe pattern that would have been planned by a guillocheur. He would have then programmed his lathe using a cam system and then hand-guided the guilloche device to engrave this dial. It is truly special. There's a railroad track inboard for the subseconds, and that features a concentric pattern on silver. All of the numerals themselves are applique, and you can see Patek used a watchmaker's 4. The case back is solid, which allows the watch to be thinner. It also adds a little bit more weight to the watch, as sapphire crystal is quite diffuse and light, and with the solid case back, the watch gains a little bit more of a silver dollar-like feel in the hand. The movement is Patek manufacturer caliber 215, manual wind, 18 jewels, 44-hour power reserve. It beats away at 8 beats per second, and it features a free-sprung gyromax-style architecture, 5-position adjustment, and then hand finishing, and it does bear the Ponce de Genève, the imprimatur of high horology finish in the city or canton of Geneva. The watch is water resistant to 30 meters, but really it's there for emergencies only, splash or inadvertent rain. This is not one to take swimming. It is, however, a companion for almost every other occasion. Reach out to Team Mosso at thewatchbox.com for purchase and pricing details.